County is a very special place to me. My wife is from Cobb County. Both my children were born in Kennesaw Hospital. We lived here 6 years out of college. Both my in-laws still live here across from Marietta High School, so Cobb County has been very good to me. But I'm David Pennington. I'm running for governor. I'm a private business person, not a professional politician, but I'm running to restore Georgia back to our rightful place, which is the most powerful, successful economy in the South. And I know how to do that. You do that by adhering to limited government principles. Less spending, less taxes, less regulations, and open and transparent government. It's not campaign promises to me. I've done it. As Mayor of Dalton, we cut property taxes 6 straight years by a total of almost 30%. We haven't had a countywide loss in 6 years. We've had the lowest sales tax in Georgia. We cut most business license fees from 25 to 50%. Cut the downtown development authority tax by 2/3. We're one of the first communities in America to take out traffic cameras because they're just an unnecessary revenue grab. I want people to understand that I wasn't doing this to serve myself. I contributed to my mayor's salary at Dalton State College every year to write dozens of scholarships for kids at Dalton State College. Now, how's that worked out for Dalton? 2012, Dalton ranked 9th amongst all American cities in fastest growing incomes because limited government principles work. While we're doing that in Dalton, I watched the state of Georgia, under the leadership of Nathan Deal, do just the opposite. Increased spending by $3.5 billion in less than 4 years. Raised taxes multiple ways, whether it be internet taxes, nursing home taxes, but I'm going to concentrate on one tax, the new way we tax automobiles in this state, the TABT tax. Now, this is a state that we're already the most expensive state in America to own and operate a vehicle in. The most expensive state in America to own or operate a vehicle. Not California, not New Jersey, not New York, but Georgia. More than twice the surrounding states. So we decided to come up with a new scheme to tax automobiles, which has now turned into one of the largest tax increases in Georgia history. First 8 months of this fiscal year's end, it's bringing in almost $35 million a month in new tax revenue. Now they also claim that they did away with the birthday tax. Well, first of all, if you haven't bought a new car, you're still driving an old car, you're still paying your birthday tax. But worse than that, birthday tax wasn't a state revenue source. It was a local revenue source. Very easy for me to cut the taxes in Tennessee or Mississippi. And as that birthday tax does roll off, local school boards, city councils, county commissions are going to raise your property taxes, while the state's made off with the rest of the revenue and its spending. Third, you can't operate a democracy unless you're open and transparent. And this state is as far from being open and transparent as any state you'll find in America. And I'll talk about another tax, the hospital bed tax. It was passed 4 years ago, behest of Sonny Perdue, as a temporary measure to fund Medicare. I didn't like the way they did it then, because it puts too much burden on small businesses. But at least they made the legislature vote on that tax, because our Georgia Constitution says only the legislature has the power to levy taxes. Nathan Deal came up with a better scheme for that, where so-called limited government conservatives wouldn't have to vote on a tax increase. And I know most of them are limited government conservatives because they come in front of us, campaign as that, and then they do just the opposite when they go to the state legislature. They moved that tax to an unelected board, Department of Community Health, and let them levy the tax, which they immediately did at 1.45% of hospital revenues. It brings in about $240 million a year. But the worst thing is, that unelected board has the power to take that to 6%, which will be a $1 billion tax increase, and you will never see your legislature vote on it. And they're going to do it. And how do I know they're going to do it? Because Nathan Deal said the precedent for that tax was the nursing home bed tax. They did the same thing in 2003, moving from the legislature to an unelected board, appointed by the governor, Department of Community Health. They levied that tax in 2003, $7.35 per bed per day. And this is the rate, it's at its maximum of $17.10 per bed per day. Increased 28% while Nathan Deal's been governor. The same thing's gonna happen with that hospital bed tax. Now, how's this worked out for Georgia? We have the third highest teenage unemployment rate in America. We have the fourth highest long-term unemployment rate in America, more than twice the surrounding states. We have the fifth highest poverty rate in America. And what makes that poverty rate so bad is that the four states below us are very small states. Mississippi with 2.9 million people, New Mexico with 1.9 million people. Georgia has over 10 million people, and when you have that high of a poverty rate, it's disaster brewing. It's consuming the entire state budget. Most of the jobs we've created over the last 4 years have been minimum wage and part-time jobs with no health care benefits. And Superintendent Barge alluded to, a study that just released yesterday, almost 40% of Georgians want to move out of the state of Georgia. Once again, much higher than the surrounding states. That's our present. That doesn't have to be our future. Georgia has wonderful economic assets. That's why we led the nation in per capita income growth from the 1970s to the 1990s. We trailed the saints. We've got to get back to what made Georgia great, which is limited government presence. The income tax immediately from 6% to 4% because we have the ninth highest in America and the highest in the Southeast. We need to do it for three reasons. Number one, small businesses generate 65% of the net new jobs in America. I'm a small business person. Many of you are. We pay our corporate taxes through our personal tax returns. Small businesses are dead in the water in Georgia. Secondly, for people that work for large corporations. GE Power Systems used to be headquartered in Atlanta with no other headquarters. They're now spreading that out to Texas and one other state. And why are they doing it? Because the taxes are too high in Georgia. There's no state income tax in Texas. It will immediately put $2.7 billion a year in private people's hands to spend in Georgia businesses and invest in new opportunities. Second thing we need to do on taxes, we need to allow 100% expensing of all capital purchases in the first year by all Georgia businesses. Because that will provide the best job with health care benefits and help on Medicaid also. The reason I know that, I was the mayor of the carpet capital of the world, Dolphin, Georgia, which is the last manufacturing center left in Georgia. Georgia should be a manufacturing powerhouse. We have all the assets to do that if we use the right tax and regulatory policies. We have the best ports in America. Best airport in the world, best interstate system in the South, best railroad network in the South, great universities, competitive utilities. There is no excuse for Georgia to lose more manufacturing jobs per capita than any other state in the South over the last decade, except our policies and taxes are just wrong. You can't have a 21st century economy if you don't have a 21st century education system. You can trace the decline in public education in this state, in this country. First, with the centralization of all the power and authority into state capitals, and now to Washington, D.C. 1900, only 10% of 18-year-olds had a high school diploma in this country. By 1970, 80% had a high school diploma in this country. Those 70 years was almost complete local control. I'm not just against Washington control, I'm against Atlanta control. We need to decentralize. Power authority back to local school teachers, local school boards to do what they've been so well trained to do. I can tell you from Dalton, Georgia and Winfield County, we're far better off that way. We're already funding half of it anyway. That's why I'm completely opposed to Common Core. Centralized power and authority doesn't work. That's why the Soviet Union fell apart. Why are we going down the same road? Lastly, on education, obviously we need a lot more kids in Georgia, as Nathan Deal said, going to college and technical schools. For the last 2 years Nathan Deal's been governor, for the first time since the early 1970s, we've lost kids in the university system. plan didn't seem to be working very well. Why didn't it work? Because from 2007 through 2012, the net cost to college and technical school tuition in Georgia grew by an astounding 77%. This is after all hope grants and all the scholarships. Next closest state to us, once again, we led the nation in that. It was New Mexico at 54%. California didn't grow at all. Our tuition cost is out of control. This year, they're increasing again at Georgia Tech and University of Georgia by 79%. We have got to get control of that spending, or else we're going to make sure, and we probably already have, we're going to price an education, college education, out of most typical Georgia's hands to be able to pay for it. This state's going to require bold changes to turn it around, because economic momentum works for you or against you. Many years in Georgia, from the 70s through the 90s, it worked for us, and we could go past a lot of speed bumps. Now it's working against us. Turn that around is going to require bold changes. You're not going to allow politicians you don't trust to make those bold changes. And it's once again Superintendent Barge alluded to. We rank fifth in integrity, fifth in corruption. First thing we need to do is what the state legislature and the governor's office decided a long time ago. They decided city councils, county commissions, local school boards had to be under open meeting laws. And I support open meetings laws, but they exempted themselves from them. They need to be under the same open meeting laws. Yeah. It's amazing how much better government gets when you let the sun shine in.
Yes. Yes.
The last part, obviously, I think we probably read a little bit down here about our ethics commission debacle. How can you have an ethics commission appointed by some very, very people that they have to investigate? We need a constitutional amendment that allows the judiciary to appoint the Ethics Commission, set a $7 million floor for their funding to allow them to do their job. We've got to restore the trust in order to make the changes we need to make. Georgia Republicans have been in charge of the governor's office, or so-called Republicans. We've got to remember they were Democrats. Since 2002. Legislature's been under Republican control since 2004. Explain to me how we go that long. No tax reform, no tort reform, no malpractice reform, no regulatory reform, no nothing. And how's that worked out? Yeah. But at the turn of the century, Georgia's about to crack the top 20 in every economic indicator. We were the marvel of the South. Since then, we're down to the bottom 10, not the bottom 5. And one thing about Cobb County, to me too, besides being very special because of my family, y'all have always been the bell cow, conservative movement of Georgia. Where Cobb County goes, the state goes, either way. And hopefully Cobb County will heed this wake-up call, because this is the wake-up call for the Georgia Republican Party. They got it from a party line vote that Georgia graduates voted for. They wanted the medical school, same thing. Gusta Medical does a pretty good job with it already. University of Georgia, it has the lowest space utilization rate of all the universities at 31%. It's still building. It's out of control. But believe me, you appoint people to that board to do their job, and hopefully, if you're a limited government conservative, you're going to find other limited government conservatives to operate on that board. That's what needs to happen. Yes, sir.
Problem we had, talking about financing, talking about education and things, the biggest problem it seems to me that we have here is the rise of the nanny state. And by that I mean not just in the state of Georgia, not just in the country, but all around. A lot of parents are under the mistaken idea that they think that they're put on this earth to protect their children. Nothing can be further from the truth. They're put on this earth to teach their children. So really, we live in a nasty world. Teach their children how to cope in that world. Same thing goes for government. Government is not put here to protect us. Every time somebody tells me they're protecting my bill folks, I automatically distrust that person. But the problem we've got here, we don't seem to have in the Republican Party the ability to put that into the right words where people can understand. Our message is mixed up, it's convoluted. We've got a bunch of people jumping up and saying, hey, look at me. I've got an answer. Until we solve that problem of a government, whether it be local, state or national, until we solve that problem of them running our life from birth to grave, right, we're going to have that problem. And the Republican Party gets to where they can put that message out there in a manner that will get people's attention. We're going to lose.
Well, first of all, we need to worry about it. We need to elect Republicans to believe what you just said. Most don't. The number one problem this country's got at the moment is this. In this century, I'm not talking about the 20th century that was 100 years long. I'm talking about the 21st century that was 13 years long. We've gone from first to 11th in worldwide freedom rankings. We're now below Canada. Our birthright as Americans was to live in the freest nation on earth.
Yes.
In economic freedoms. And if you fall below the 80th percentile, you're no longer considered a free economy, you're considered a mostly free economy. We fell to the 79th percentile last year. Every politician, you don't remember anything else I said today, every politician comes before you. I don't care if it's Congress, Senate, state legislature, governor, county commission, school board member, or city council member. Ask them one question. What are you going to do to give me back my birthright, which is to live in the freest nation on earth? Thank you.
Yeah.